What's in your shadow? What is in your shadow? Praise God. Hallelujah. Does your shadow heal? Okay, nobody say that. What is in your shadow? Praise God. What is in my shadow? And that's a question that all of us need to ask of ourselves. And maybe we need to ask a few other people that they would say, what do you see in my shadow? Now, we understand that a shadow is a reflection of light.
Yes.
Y'all miss what I said?
Yes, it is.
Uh-huh. I said a shadow is a reflection of light.
That's right.
Light is hitting you in such a way that it throws a reflection of who you really are. But it's the light that's causing the reflection.
Yeah, yeah.
So how much light is on you?
Lord, have mercy. What
Amen.
What you say?
How much light is on you? How much of the light are you personally reflecting? Now don't say, well, the church ain't doing this and the church ain't doing that. Talk to me about your shadow. What is in your shadow? Now, the Bible says in Acts chapter number 5, and when you get there, say, I'm there.
I'm there.
If you're on your way, say, I'm on my way. Now, this is kind of where we left off, and I want to talk a little bit about this. In Acts chapter number 5, verse number 15, and when you get there, say, I'm there. Let's get ready to read. Amen.
I'm there.
All right, let's get ready to read Acts chapter number 5. Acts chapter number 5. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Am I on? Turn it on. Everybody help. Turn it all down. She's learning. Would y'all give Lily a hand? Yeah. Is it on? All right. It's on. You might be on the wrong channel, Elder. All right. Acts chapter number 5, verse number 15. All right? Mm-hmm. And when you get there, say, I'm there.
I'm there.
Let's read. So much so that they brought the sick out into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might fall on some of them. Verse 16, also a multitude gathered from the surrounding cities to Jerusalem, bringing sick people and those who were tormented by unclean spirits, and they were all healed. Wow.
All healed.
Wow. All healed. Now, the first thing that we have to know is this is totally possible today.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
I've seen it work. I know that it's possible. I've seen it work so many times in my own life. There is an attraction when a person is really walking in grace. There is an attraction to it. Remember, great grace was upon them all, right? Great grace was upon them all. So all of them that were there, they had this supernatural favor on their lives.
Oh, yes.
Say this with me. I have supernatural favor on my life.
On my life.
Great grace,
great grace
is upon me.
It's upon me.
Turn to somebody and say, great grace is on you too.
Great grace is on you too.
Amen. Great grace is upon us all.
Yeah,
great grace is on you.
I say great grace is upon us all. The Lord declared that Acts 4 and 33 was now the season for this house and the people connected to us. Great grace.
Great grace
is upon us.
Thank you, Lord. I'm glad.
Now, Peter did not have time to lay hands on all those people.
Look at God.
So they just brought all of the sick and the broken and the maimed and the hurting, and they just laid them in the streets.
Oh,
that perhaps.
Yeah.
That was my good friends. Yes, I love those girls. Polly and Esther, they're my dear friends. Amen. They call me something else now, but it's just Polly and Esther. And so I would cut them up. We would come in the office, Pat and I and Christy and others, and we would lay out the garments, and I would start praying over the garments, and we would be cutting them. And by the time it was over, we had bags and bags of little squares. And so at that time, we probably had about 30,000, 40,000 partners that was a part of Go Tell It Ministry. around the world. We were really traveling and really building our partner base. And those partners were sowing seed every month. So at the beginning of the year, what I would do is that I would put a handkerchief or a piece of towel or dress, whatever I used, in their mail that month. And that was a point of contact for the supernatural to take place. A prayer cloth, point of contact. And I cannot tell you the letters and the miracles when people would see me out on the road, how that prayer cloth, people got saved. And they would write the office, call the office. We didn't have cell phones and all that internet stuff, they had to call. And they would want another prayer cloth. So every first of the year, they wanted Evangelist Harris's prayer cloths and the miracles that took place, the signs and wonders that took place. That was amazing. I believe that God is waiting, just waiting on people who will do it. Yeah. Just believe. Yeah. I figured that the same virtue that flowed through me when I was in their presence was the same virtue yet in my life.
Yeah.
I told you the story Sunday, and my daughter was laughing at me, but I told it. It's the truth. When Cookie could not grow hair, the Lord said, don't even pray for her, give her your comb.
Wow.
And I gave her my comb in that shirt. I said, somebody bring me my comb. I said, then you comb your scalp. And she began to comb that scalp that hair began to grow.
Yeah.
And today, Cookie got hair.
Yeah.
And she kept that comb. Okay, y'all not saying that. Jewish exorcists took it upon themselves to call the name of the Lord Jesus over those who had evil spirits, saying, we exorcise you by the Jesus whom Paul preaches. And there were seven sons of Sceva, a Jewish chief priest, who did so. And the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, Paul I know, but who are you? And the man in whom the evil spirit leaped on them, overpowered them, and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of that house naked and wounded. Y'all not hearing me? This is not magic. Write this down. This is relationship. Relationship with Jesus Christ. Communion with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
So that means that you have to nurture, you have to develop, you have to commune with the Lord. You have to commune in the Spirit. You have to pray in the Spirit. You have to develop a relationship with the Word of God.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
What is in your shadow? Oh Lord Jesus, what is in your shadow?
Oh Lord.
Is there anger in your shadow?
Wow.
Is there unforgiveness in your shadow?
Wow.
Is there bitterness in your shadow? What's in your shadow? Are you sassy? Are you insolent? Are you disrespectful? Is that in your shadow? Are you rude? What's in your shadow? Are you unfriendly, unapproachable? Don't like people? Some of us carry a do not disturb sign on our the hillsides and do not disturb. That's your shadow. So there's no attraction. You don't have any attraction. People are not attracted. Your shadow sends out the message that you do not want anyone in your space.
Yeah. Wow.
You don't want anyone close to you. Mm. Some of us need to work on, we need to really work on our personalities. Mm-hmm. I'm not talking about the anointing now, I'm talking about your personality.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about just your common self, the one that you put in the shower, the one that you brush your teeth, that one. Not friendly, not inviting. Not engaging. I hear people, I hear saints say this one, you know, I just don't do good with people. What do you do good with animals? I don't do good with people, you know. Some people, I have to check them all out. Really? Those are learned behaviors that you need to be delivered from.
Yes. Yes.
Because that impacts your shadow.
Yes.
That mars the reflection of the Holy Spirit of God. Are you an arguer? Are you sarcastic? Are you condemning? Are you nitpicking? Can you find fault in everything?
Wow. Oh, wow.
Nobody right, nobody gets it right with you. Nobody can do it right. Are you brash? Do you need temperance? Is your mouth quicker than your brain? You talk so fast, you're always on the defense. That mars your shadow. You can't just tell somebody off over here and then walk over here and work with them.
That's right.
Are you an arguer? Are you easily provoked? Do you have certain personality flaws that over the years you have ignored that you know you need to work on? Are you a person that is distrustful? You don't trust nobody. I don't trust nobody. You knew what I went through, you can trust nobody either. Do you know what that does in your shadow? Your aura is so off. There's so much negativity coming from you. There is no light. There is no energy from you that invites people to even approach you. Why would you want the Holy Spirit to move in your life in a mighty way if you don't like it? Who do you think the Holy Ghost is for? The pots and pans and pots.